Okay, good morning, students. Welcome back once again for your online classes. Okay, if you watched the previous videos, I've done the chapter Judiciary. The Judiciary is the last chapter from Section B. Understood? So in the last section, Section B, Judiciary, in the last video if you have watched, I've done up to conditions essential for independence of judiciary. Up to that topic I had covered. Okay, so today in this video, I'll be discussing about the Supreme Court in India. Because in this chapter, if you remember the syllabus, we have to study about the Supreme Court in India as well as the Supreme Court in India and USA. Which means in these two countries, the highest court, the apex court is the Supreme Court. Clear? So today in this video, I'll only be discussing about Supreme Court in India. Now, India, USA, as I said, Supreme Court is the highest court of appeal, the apex court. Understood? So here, now, in this particular video, as I mentioned here in the board itself, we'll be studying about the appointment of the judges, okay, the membership, the tenure, okay, and removal. How can the judges be removed from their post? So these are the topics which will be covered in today's video. Understood? So number one, as I already said, India, highest level court, apex court, Supreme Court. Now, since India is the highest level court, the apex court, which means all decisions taken by the Supreme Court, clear, cannot be challenged in any other courts. This means the decision taken by the Supreme Court in India is the final decision. No one can challenge it, no one can change it. Whereas the decisions taken by the judges of a high court can be changed, can be challenged. But decisions here given by the Supreme Court is considered to be the final decision. Clear? Which means no one can go against it, no one can change it. Understood? Now, next I come to is organization of the Supreme Court. Here in the board itself, we can see organization means how many judges, the membership. Okay, so in India, we have a total membership of 30 judges, including one Chief Justice. Clear? So in India, the membership is 30 judges with one Chief Justice of India. Then we come to appointment. Here, how can the judges of a Supreme Court be appointed? So here, judges are appointed by the president, please remember. But after consulting with some judges of High Court, some judges of the Supreme Court. Which means here, regarding appointment of the judges, president alone cannot take decisions. Because since, as you already know, executive chapter we've done this, president is just a nominal head. Clear? So he never takes decisions on his own. So therefore here, regarding appointment of the judges also, president does it, but after consulting with certain judges of Supreme Court and certain judges of the High Court. Clear? Then you come to the term or the tenure. That is, what is the term or tenure of a Supreme Court judge? So here, the Supreme Court judge holds his tenure up to the age of 65 years. That is, 65 years is his age of his retirement. Clear? Which means he is there in his post, he works as a judge up to the age of his retirement, which is 65 years. Which means before that, clear, he can be removed, but there is a special procedure, special grounds on which he can be removed. Because remember, judges belonging to your top high-ranking officers, which means they cannot be easily removed from their post. It's very, very difficult to remove a judge from his post. Clear? So though we say tenure is 65 years, that is up to the age of the retirement. Clear? But under certain circumstances, he can be removed. And the removal process is called the process of impeachment, which is a very, very difficult procedure. Why? Because no one can be easily removed from his post. Now, here the question is, how and when is he impeached? Clear? Now here, the judge can be impeached on different grounds. For example, if he violates the rules and regulations of the Constitution. Clear? Secondly, if he shows any kind of misconduct, any kind of misbehavior, then he can be impeached. Otherwise, he cannot be easily removed from his post. Clear? So that is impeachment. Understood? So what I've done is tenure. Clear? Organization, appointment, these are just basic things. And apart from that, the Supreme Court enjoys two special jurisdictions, which I mentioned here. One is court, which means high court are there. We have district courts, we have subordinate courts, but we have Supreme Court at the highest level. Clear? So here, certain cases are there which cannot be taken to any other court, but has to be directly taken to the Supreme Court. So this is called original jurisdiction. Means certain cases are there which can originate, which can be directly taken only to the Supreme Court. Cannot be taken to any other court, be it the High Court, District Court, or other lower level courts. This is called original jurisdiction. Now, the second type of jurisdiction, appellate. Clear? Which comes from the word appeal. Now, what does appeal mean? We ask for help. You're requesting someone, isn't it? So here, appellate jurisdiction means the Supreme Court here, that is why we say that, Supreme Court here acts as a court of appeal. Means it hears the appeal, pleas, the appeals, the requests which are made by the lower level courts. Which means if High Court is not able to give decision on a particular case, what can the High Court do? Make an appeal to the Supreme Court. Or, for example, just the other way around. If we citizens, if you file a case in the Supreme Court, sorry, High Court, and you're not satisfied with the decision of the High Court, what can you do? You can make an appeal to the Supreme Court. Clear? And it is the duty of the Supreme Court to hear the appeals which are made by the people, which are made by the lower level courts. That is why Supreme Court is also known as the Court of Appeal. Clear? So I'll not go into too much detail, original, appellate, because I'll be doing it in the next class. Today I've just explained in brief what is meaning of appellate, what is meaning of original. Clear? So this much for today. So next class, same chapter, same topic. Thank you.